Hey guys, I'm Ozya, and welcome to another episode. Last episode, we did the engine controllers, which essentially control the engine, specifically these gasoline engines. And basically, you could set the speed of the engines. And I think in an early episode, I said that since these grinders only need 32 rads, to work in these engines could do 512. I did say you were effectively wasting power. So that's not exactly true, to an extent. And I think I might be incorrect in thinking that way. I'm going to rephrase it as to say that if you need to do grind through 100 canola seeds in a certain amount of time, and you can achieve that by having the engine going over at 50% speed. If it goes at 100% speed, then you're going to get points where the grinder will be working with no seeds going through at all. So those bits of time will actually be wasted. Obviously, you could increase the amount of seeds, and then you would be wasting that the fuel in there, but of course then you get extra canola and you just be building up a supply of canola. So the engine controls, essentially you can limit the engines to a speed that's needed to do the job load that you want it to do, as opposed to having points where you haven't got enough canola seeds or enough materials to be grinded to be useful to your current situation. Whatever you think. Oh, Enderman, don't look. I'm going to press F7 so those X's aren't appearing as well. Okay, so what we're going to do today is we're going to get onto automatic farming. These are canola seeds at the moment. Canola plants, I should say. So what we're going to do is we're going to build a farm. Not a farm. A fan. That was close. It starts with an F. A RotaryCraft fan. We're also going to be needing a DC electric engine, which for the time being, you know, I should have built one before the episode, but I'm not. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to break this one because I won't be using that machine just for the time being. We're going to use this one. And we're going to be needing a gearbox just to increase the speed of the DC electric engine. The DC engine has enough power and enough torque to turn a fan. However, the fan itself requires a certain rad speeds to be useful in farming. And so we're just going to get on to making that. What are we going to make first? The gearbox or the fan? That needs the gearbox one. That's the fan one. So we'll grab the fan one. So basically the fan is a shaft. Base panel, wood around the outer side, and then the inside is an impeller. Just weird that it needs a minimum of 1.24 kilowatts, which is the power output of a DC electric engine. If we look at it should be in the RotaryCraft book under farming, fan. If we go to the side, we'll notice that harvesting speed requires 512. Rads, a DC engine gives off at 256, so we're going to need to double that, hence the gearbox. So let's get working on the gearbox. Not that one. We need to make the gears first. So we're going to make a wooden gearbox. It's the simplest and cheapest, of course. And we're going to need to make wooden gears, which is pretty simple. It's a cross pattern of spruce. You're going to need to make at least two of them. Actually, I'm going to make a couple more just to demonstrate how to make more complicated gearboxes. Okay, like that, and so forth. So to make a gearbox, you essentially need to just make one gear, which in our case we need a 2x gear, which is essentially two gears, and then a wooden stick, and a wooden stick gives you two gears. Now, if you wanted to make a 4x gearbox, you essentially make 2x gearboxes. I'm going to need two more sticks. And you essentially put them together and you get 4x gears. And what we would do is you would take this part And then you need to put it into the gearing, but we're not going to do that. I need the 2x gears. So I'm going to go to a work table, put in a couple of planks down the bottom in a U-shape, put the gear in the center, and we give our gearbox. And so now we've got all the parts. Need to put them in the right place. So with most things, the input is facing away from you. So we'll just break that for the time being. So, and you can see, and when you put it, the blue box shows up the output, really. Specifically machines that don't output power, but they output some kind of force. If we get our angular transducer, we can see that again. Blue is the way the fan's gonna blow. Green is the input. We're gonna need to put a gearbox there. And then on the end of that, we need to put a, you know what? We also need a redstone circuit, so. Not that one, this one. Okay, let's go get that gear, not gear, a lever. I'm always having to make, or go get levers. I've got some here, there we go. Okay, before we turn this whole thing on, the gearbox itself requires lubrication. And this is what we made from the canola seeds, which we've grinded. I've stored it in a BuildCraft tank. And where are they? I've already got them, lubrication pipes. To get the lubricant out of a BuildCraft tank, it's pretty simple. You just place a lubricant pipe underneath. As you can see, the pipes do take up quite a bit of lubricant themselves. So actually, let's run this like this. As you can see, the lubricant pipe automatically attaches to the sides of gearboxes. Okay, let's go this way, this way, this way. Run across the water. Like that, up. And as you can see, the lubricant drains through the lubricant pipes, goes over to our gearbox. You can actually see whether or not there's lubricant in there. The whale is telling us that it's filling up as well. And it should fill up to about, I think, 4 or 3 buckets. Yep, 3 buckets. More complicated gearboxes, specifically the material the gearbox is made out of, such as stone, steel, and diamond, and bedrock. Actually, scrap bedrock. Those ones will have higher containers, as in they can store more than 3 buckets. Bedrock doesn't require any lubricant at all, so it doesn't have a storage system for it, really. Okay, so now we've got that going. If we right-click on it, we see that the gearbox is... Actually, it doesn't say if it's in what mode it's in. We just right click it, we get a UEI, it says it's torque mode, which essentially means it's doubling the torque output. It does say power zero because we haven't got the tension turned on. The engine puts at 256 watts, so we need to turn it into speed mode. The way of doing that is get your screwdriver out and shift right click on it. It will then change it into speed mode. As you can see, the UEI now says, what do I call it, UEI? It's UI. UI says it's speed, and it's on a ratio of 2 because it's a 2 speed ratio gearbox. Let's put the gearbox down. Okay. Before we turn this on, we should probably put something at the end of this to collect the canola seeds. So I've got a chest here, and we're going to try and collect them with a hopper. Set up like that, and we're just going to use some wood for the time being to block the canola seeds from going any further. Okay, that should be right. Hopefully I've got everything correct. I'm going to turn the gearbox on. As you can see, it's still collecting them, and boys not. With the RotaryCraft farming, my words, something's going off my brain, I don't know. You'll notice it. That the plant doesn't disappear itself, it merely goes back to its first growth stage, which is 0% for these ones, and then when they grow to full stage again, they'll get broken again, so they do get collected by the hopper. And now we've got our canola seeds. Then from what then on, I'll probably run a pipe from this all the way over to the grinder, and we'll have that automatic canola seed, lubricant gone again. So Let's just put this one in there. If I got my watering can, yes, I have. We can get a little bit more. Tell what, it's really good to see RotaryCraft back. Not back, but it's good to see it in 1.7.10. Rake is working on version 2 of the RotaryCraft, so hopefully there's new features, and there's definitely bug features. I mean, bug features? Well, it's RotaryCraft, there's going to be bug features. I love them too. But there's going to be bug fixes. There we go. Once they get to 100%, which this one will soon, it's at 88%. Should break. But it's being stubborn. I should also note that if you get your angular transducer again, once it's being received power, and if you right click on it, that blue section informs you of the range at how far it will break. Down the bottom it says it's got a range of 7 meters. You'll note that the blue line actually goes out to 8 blocks, and I've noticed that sometimes the items themselves will be blown up to 9 blocks. So I would keep with the idea of it set being 7 blocks, because that 8 and 9 blocks distance may not happen every single time. Another good thing to note about this is that if you have plants on either side of this row, it can, or it most likely will, harvest those plants as well. However, the items that get dropped from those plants, if they drop on these blocks here or on this side here, they will not be picked up by the wind and will not be pushed down there. So if you have some kind of thing like a vacuum hopper or something like that, or a item vacuum that can pick up items from the side, then you can use one fan for a row of three. And also with all RotaryCraft machines supplying more power, more speed, different variant types will change the output of the, it'll essentially affect the machine, and the machine will act differently. In which case, the fans, you're either going to get a longer range, or maybe even a shorter range, depending on what you do about it. These things are also capable of spreading fires. So that should tell us in the RotaryCraft book, under farming, high speeds can also be used to uproot crops and harvest them. And you can use them to put out or spread fires. So what does it say? Harvesting speed. Fire extinguish at 64 rads. So I would imagine if you've got a fan that's got going slower than 64 rads, it would potentially spread fire. So this is might be a neat way of, I don't know, it's mob traps, cooking pigs. Be interesting. That's about it for today, guys. Got any questions, let me know below. Please like the video. Hopefully, I'm going to set a goal. Can we get 15? Can we get 15? 15 would be awesome. Do I have 16? Do I have 16? Maybe 17? 17? 18 in the back? Maybe 18? Going once? Twice? No, just liking would be help. Alright, thanks guys. Subscribe, that helps too. Until next time. Ready, aim, fire.